Herman, I need to show you how to use email. I said, I don't need to learn email. Yes, you do. I said, I have a secretary. What are you there for? She said, no, Herman, you need to learn email because this is how people are going to communicate in the future. I said, well, I just don't think I need to learn how to do that. It was intimidating. You want me to learn email? That's something from Future Shock. Kicking and screaming. I learned how to use that desktop computer and learned how to use email. And that was just 1999. You guys were using email before you graduated from the grill. You can't imagine life without email, Twitter, and Facebook. It just wouldn't seem normal, would it? But that didn't even exist back then. I was a computer science major in graduate school, graduated in 1971 from Purdue University with a master's in computer science. Everything that I learned in computer science no longer exists. It is outdated, okay, doesn't matter. I remember one of the big discussions that we had when I was in graduate school in 1971 as a computer science major. One of the big discussions we had was something called distributed processing. Because back then, computers were big boxes that filled up rooms. IBM, Honeywell, CDC, they called them the big boxes. And then there was a move toward what you call distributed processing. Instead of having one big box at corporate to do all of your computer processing, they would put one in the southeast, one in the southwest, one on the west coast. You spread your risk of everything getting messed up if something goes down. They call that distributed processing. Then all of a sudden people started having, you didn't have to go to the computer department to get stuff run. Somebody came up with the idea, well, let's put a computer on everybody's desk. So distributed processing went from the big boxes to the regional boxes, to the boxes on every desk. And today, everybody has a big box computer in their cell phone.